In question 26, two equations with two unknowns are given to you. A plus b is 1 and a square plus b square is 4. Now this is a typical situation where you can solve these two equations simultaneously, provided you know how to solve them simultaneously and find the value of a, find the value of b independently, and substitute those values in this equation, what is required to be found out, and get the final answer. That is one way of doing it, but for that you require theory of quadratic equation. Okay, so those who know theory of quadratic equation can solve it using that. But let me show you another method by which we can solve this. Because there is a square involved in the final expression, because there is b square involved in the final expression, we would like to substitute b square upon 2a, b square upon 2 plus a, plus a square upon 2 plus b. We substitute value of b square. B square is 4 minus a square upon 2 plus a, plus, and a square is 4 minus b square, 4 minus b square upon 2 plus b. Now you will observe that numerator is a difference of squares, So x square minus y square is equal to x plus y into x minus y. We must know this identity. Okay. So numerator can be written as 2 plus a into 2 minus a divided by 2 plus a. Oh, that is good. Plus 2 minus 2 plus b, 2 minus b divided by 2 plus b. Now you will observe that this 2 plus a, and that is how the problem is designed. Therefore, it becomes so easy. And therefore, we end up getting 2 minus a plus 2 minus b is equal to 4 minus a plus b. Now we want numerical value of this. Therefore, we must know what is a plus b. And a plus b is given to us. It is 4 minus 1, which is equal to 3. So 3 is the answer. However, using quadratic equation, using quadratic equation, what we will have to do is a is equal to 1 minus b. And therefore, put this value of a into this equation, we get 1 minus b bracket square plus b square is equal to 4. And now it is a quadratic in b, which we should be able to solve. And maybe the value of b is not that good. We don't know. Unless we calculate, we will not come to know what is the value of b. But then, by this method, practically we are not finding out value of a and b. We are directly finding out the answer. So the idea is, if you end up getting into a very difficult theory to be applied for these kind of problems, you might think of some other method, shortcut method, some other way of looking at things, which will give you the direct answer without getting into the difficult calculations. That is what this question tells us.